Okay, so we are going to use, so today's topic is Desmos. Desmos is a mathematical tool. Okay, basically Desmos will be your graphing tools. Graphical tools, okay. So graphical tools you're going to use for different mathematical equation. And construction of graph. Now, there are two things I have written. One about mathematical equation, second is construction of graph. So Desmos will help you to from an object, suppose any mathematical object has been given. Okay, mathematical object is given. So you can just use mathematical object and then you put it into Desmos and you can find equation of that mathematical object. Okay, this equation can be formed as a form of linear, quadratic, cubic, polynomial, any kind of. Okay, so what are the characteristics of linear, quadratic and those things that already you have studied in different of your classes? And how this linear, quadratic and those are look like and how their graphics are. Now you are going to study here how to use your Desmos tool to find the equation of unknown, what is called unknown graph. Okay, this is one part. And the second one I'd like to mention here, another one, that is this one, that is number two, that's construction of graph. That means if you have some equation, mathematical equation, you can use that, okay, to construct graph. Okay, so graph, why you're going to construct the graph? Because this will help you to understand varieties of your unknown things. Unknown things in the way of what is called different values, different perspectives. So these are the things, these are the tools we are very, very important, and what is called, it will give you an understanding on how you're going to evaluate or interpret the system or data or future aspects. Okay, so let begins with another part of it. Just let me take you through Desmos and we are going to explain over there. I think my Desmos is visible for you, my screen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the tool, desmos.com. You can just let me mark some of the places where you have to do what, and these things is very important. First thing, this is the site, and this is a digital site. Even they have some what is called app and those things also you can download. But this one is working fine. This one here you can find there's a graphic. Graphing calculator. So the graphing calculator will help you to graph different things. They're going to teach you of that. They have for students and they have for teachers also. Okay, so these are the main thing, and we are going to take it further. So let's see how it is. Okay, so these are the visualized things that are, what are the things you can construct and mathematical diagram, you can find it out. Okay, so let's begin with the thing that is graphics calculator. So your graphing calculator will look like this way. It is loading actually. Okay, so you can see untitled graphs. The total graph page has been shown where this one is denoted as, this is for x-axis and this is for your y-axis. Okay, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. So this is my negative x-axis, we call it x-dash, and this is my y negative axis, we call it y-dash. Okay, so this one is there. Okay, and this is the area where you can put your mathematical equation. Okay. For example, suppose I am going to take as y equals to suppose 3x plus 2. Okay. So let's see how it is going to work. You have to type y equals to 3x plus 2. You already know that this one is what is called this mathematical expression. So this one is, you know, this is a linear equation, right? This is a linear equation. So linear equation means it has a straight line graph. So you can see that there's a straight line graph. So straight line graph over here. So, and what are the points it's touching to the x-axis, y-axis? This is one point. So that means this point is 0, 2. That is y value has 2. And this one is, if you're going to take your cursor and put it over there, so you'll get to know what is the coordinates are there. So this is very easy way to identify. This is 0, 2, this one way. And this is another one is negative 0.667 and 0. So what are they, where they are, what are intersecting each other, that also you can find it out. So let's take another example. Suppose if you take your cursor over there and press enter, so next part of the equation will be open up. So I'm taking another equation, suppose y equals to minus 2x plus 1. Suppose I'm taking this equation. So once I take this equation, you can see there are a few colors also are highlighting over here. This is red color. So this graph also denoting in red. Sorry, I'm using green. So this one also denoting in red. And if you see there is a blue color thing over here. Okay, so even the graph also colored over blue. So you can identify easily that this is the equation for first one. And this is the equation for second one. Okay, you can identify easily. Now, next part of the equation is next part of the things you need to check. What is the cross section over here, right? What is the cross section? So that means intersecting point. What is the solution between these two equations? So if you are going to find equation one and equation two, okay, the process of finding equation one, equation two, we use simultaneous equation solving. Am I clear? The simultaneous equation, okay, solving process we use. There are different kind of process. Somebody is using eliminating process. Some people using substitution method, equality of the method. Okay, there are many methods that are there for simultaneous equation. Okay. So if you're going to solve this one, these two equations, let's see that how it is coming. So thereafter we'll come to graph part. Suppose if you solve this manually, so I have y equals to 3x plus 2. So I should get minus 3x plus y, that is equals to 2. This is my equation number one. And my second equation is y equals to minus 2x plus 1. So minus means this is going to be plus 2x plus y equals to 1. So this is my equation number 2. Now, generally, we are keeping this two equation together, right? If you're going to write this one, like I'm writing in the right side, minus 3x plus y equals to 2 and 2x plus y equals to 1. Then the elimination method means we change the sign over here. Am I correct? Yes, then we are canceling this, YY cancel. So minus 3x minus 2x is giving minus 5x. And this is 2 minus 1 means 1. So x is become my negative 1/5. So what next we are doing? After that, we substitute the value into any of the equation. So any of the equation, suppose y equals to 3x, x means 1 minus negative 1/5 plus 2. So if you're going to solve it, minus 3/5 plus 2, that means it will be 5 to the 10, that means 7/5. 7/5, 1/5, if you check, that means this cross-section, I'm talking about this cross-section values should be negative 1/5 and 7 over 5. Now, next question, if you're going to convert a fraction to decimal, you are going to get 1 over 5 means it is 0.2. So I would get over here, that means 0.2 and 7 over 5, okay, 7 divided by 5, we'll get 1.4. So 1.4. So this should be our, what is called, solution point. If you are solving in simultaneous equation method. So let's see what graph is saying now. Okay, if you're going to touch over here. Okay, so let me take eraser. Yeah, you can see now. You can see now what is the answer is showing in a graph, negative 0.2 and 1.4, and what we have received when you are solving simultaneous equation. Okay, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so now I would suggest that you try it, and desmos.com, go to calculator. I'm giving you some equation over here, so you try to solve that equation. Okay, so let me just clear my screen and let me give you an equation. Suppose you will open your desmos.com equation. I'm giving pair of equations, actually equations. I suppose first pair I'm giving 3x plus 2y equals to 1 and 5x minus 2y equals to 3. Second pair of equation, x plus y equals to 5, x minus y equals to 10. Third pair of equation, 1 by 5x plus 1 by 2y equals to 1. Negative 1 by 2x plus 1 by 5y equals to 1. Number 4, I'm giving 7x minus 3y equals to 15. And 4x plus 4x plus equals 5y equals to 25. Okay, these are the four equations you are going to try using Desmos. So let's begin. Give me the first equation. What is the first equation? What is the first equation?
Three x plus 2y equals 1.
3x plus 4y equals to
1. 2. 2y equals 1.
Okay. And the second
one? 2y.
4x, 3x plus 2y, right?
Equals 1.
Equals 1. Okay. And the second one? Second equation?
Five x.
Minus
27.
No, not 27, I think 2y.
Oh.
2y equals?
Yeah, it has to be y.
Three, yeah, equals 3.
Equals 3. So you can see that when you're going to draw, immediately it has come 3 points, okay? So the 3 points are, the first value is the solution, solution. Second one, if I take, it is touching the x-axis, and this is where it is touching y-axis. Okay, that means we call them, this one has a y-intercept when you are, when you're getting y-intercept, that means when you're going to write y equals to x plus c. So now for the second equation, first equation, this is your y-intercept, this is your x-intercept, and this is your solution. So we are getting the solution as in the form of 0.5 and minus 0.25. Okay, so this one is your solution of these two equations. Okay, let's try with the second one. What was the second equation? Okay, let's begin with the second equation.
X plus y.
How much?
X plus y equals 5.
X plus y equals 5. And the second one?
X minus y.
X plus y equals to 5. And x minus y?
Equals 10.
Equals how much? Equals to how much?
10.
10?
Yeah.
Okay. So x plus y equals to 5, x minus y equals to 10. So here the equation is coming over here. The solution is here. You can see the solution is 7.5 minus 2.5. That is these are the two equations which are intersecting together. Okay. So this is uses of these two lines cross section. Okay. Try with the third one. Okay. So tell me the third equation. What's the third equation?
One by five.
Okay. X.
Plus. 1/2 y.
1/2 y.
Equals one.
Second one.
Minus 1/2.
-1/2. X.
Yeah.
One
plus
five. Y equals to
one.
So see, these are the two equation, and when it is already given as a fraction, but it is giving you the solution that is over here, that is -1.34 and 2.414. Okay. So this is the solution for the third one, and now next try the fourth one as well. What was the fourth equation? Fourth equation, please.
Seven x minus three y equals 15.
Second one.
Four x plus five y equals 25.
So if you make them equation, so immediately the solution is coming over here. Okay, this is the, so it will save you time. What is the purpose of learning this tools? Because when you're going to appear at the examination, then one paper will be around 2 hours. So within 2 hours, if you're going to do everything manually, it will be difficult for you to finish your paper. So now, I was getting this fraction or something. If you're getting confused, there is a tool over here that's called keyboard. The keyboard, there are so many options over here. So these are the things you can use it for: power, for less than, greater than, anything. Okay. And now function also there, like tan, cosine, sat function, distribution function, and miscellaneous also given. Okay. Miscellaneous means nth power, summation, integration, logarithm, whatever there in your calculator, everything has been given over here. Now, let's begin with an equation that whatever the same equation, if I am going to change this equal to sign with this greater than equals to, and this 25 as less than equals to, what will happen? So this is the beauty of this tool. So you can check this tools now. This is giving you an idea that what is the area covering between these two in equation. When you're going to talk about less than equals to or greater than equals to, we use inequality, right? So there are two in equation, equation number one, equation number two, which is giving the area, that means the solution area are covering over here. So now what is the difference between an equation and an inequation? Equation gives exact value, right? What is the perfect solution? Okay, equation gives exact value. What is the perfect solution? And inequation, okay, inequation giving a solution area. So this is the solution area, which is a combination of these two colors. Whatever is less than greater than symbol is coming for. So you can see when you're going to put a greater than or less than symbol, this is denoting some of the area that which is showing that which area is your common area and which is denoted by the particular equation. Okay? Okay? So this is the form of inequation equation with linear values. Now, if I take it to the next step, what will happen? If you're going to the quadratic equation, let's take an example of quadratic equation and then we'll end this session for today. So next class, again, definitely we are going to take it further. Now, how are you going to place the power? I said that there's an option of this one, a power b, s squared. Suppose I'm taking x squared, so I'll put s squared. Otherwise, you can use use keyboard also. Okay, that is also fine. So y equals to x square, we are going to put it, it is going to be like this. Okay, U shape. You know, this is a, if I'm going to put x square plus 2x plus 1, so this will be my parabolic equation where the vertex, which is over here, okay, you touch over there, so you'll get to know what is the vertex and without any calculation. Okay, so if you just put it over here, so you'll get to know what is that. And if you want to know what is the y-intercept, that is also over here. Okay, so if you just place it over here, then you'll get to know what is the y-intercept of this equation and then where it has a vertex. Okay, so what is the help of this one? So you'll get line of symmetry. Line of symmetry means this one is, you can just, if I'm going to draw a line through this vertex, right? So I'm going to get this one is minus one. So x equals to minus one, that is will be my line of symmetry, right? So many things you are going to predict or you can use it but to get different kind of questions answers, okay? So this is just in one process that how you're going to do that. Next session, actually, we are going to take it further for how you're going to develop this quadratic, even cubic, and how you are going to use different object and get the equation.